weights, but no the fuck you did. You were born in the mid-80s and grew up in the South. You listen to FM Country Music Radio. I don't give a fuck what you told yourself. That's what you listen to. And that's what I listen to. I don't care. My taste developed later, but these songs hold a very, very special place in my heart. And so we made a cover record called Slappers, Bangers, and Certified Players, Volume 1. And it's fun because we released it, and a lot of people got it. A lot of people understood it. A lot of people were like, man, these guys are just paying homage to like the songs that like kind of made the musical roadmap that became who they were as teenagers and then as adults. And then there's some people, like fucking Linda on Twitter. The day I put that thing out, Linda tweets us. I don't know if Linda's not following us. I do not follow Linda. But Linda heard Slappers, Bangers, and Certified Twangers Volume 1 and decided, I've got to get on Twitter and tell this guy my opinion. So she fucking logs in on her smart device, finds my page, and tweets at me, I like Faith Hill's version better. Well, no fucking shit, Linda. I'm not trying to out-sing Faith Hill. I'm not trying to win a fucking CMA. I'm just trying to have fun with my friends during a global fucking pandemic! I was a lot calmer. I feel like I took it all caps and Ray, you guys, I did not take it all caps. I'm gonna screw it. We're going to leave you with a song off that record tonight, and like I said, we're going to be standing at the back of the room. I would love to meet you. I would love to shake your hand, and if you come for love, I'll give you a big fucking hug, because I haven't hugged people in 16 fucking months, and I miss it. But if you don't feel comfortable, understand, I'll hug the shit out of you next time, if you're comfortable. But anyway, this is my grandmother's favorite country singer. Growing up, she used to say really awkward, creepy things about this man that I didn't fully understand the depth of until I became a teenager and thought back what she meant when she said this. And I'm pretty sure if my grandmother had a chance to cheat on my grandfather at a state fair or a chili cook-off with this man, she most certainly would. This is one of my all-time favorite Sammy Kershaw songs. Thank you guys so much for being here.